Hello, Kim K here. Coming with another Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle video. And today we are doing the 8th anniversary battle event. So we are doing the first anniversary now. So we're gonna see how that goes. Before I forget, got to do that. So yeah. Alright, let's go. Let's see. Okay, this is not tough. Oh. Okay. Yeah. It's a golden freezer, he has a golden body. It's a worship golden freezer. There's a golden Frieza. There's a golden Frieza. He has a golden body. If we worship golden Frieza. Oh yeah, I forgot to introduce the team. I'm using Cooler. Why Rainbow this event. So I'm really curious to see how he performs. My recently rainbowed golden Frieza. Can't wait to test him out. Need to give him some equips. I'm thinking of giving him crit equipment. So that his active skill can do damage. That is what I want to do. My rainbow metal cooler. Because metal cooler is a beast. He is really good. I'm using this Frieza. Frieza is also good. Your Nimba is an animal. So I really want to show him off. Maybe I have an equip and give him some 10 drops and 4 additional. And I'm using FTR Transforming Cooler. Because he is also really good. So now that we have discussed this, so let's continue. I don't think that that he will have a second phase. Yeah, no second phase. I think I went too over the top for this. Let's do this, and this, and this. Go met de koeler. Nice. De Nimba. Daar went hij easy. Let's do the next fight also, but I will have to put the sound a bit softer. That way we can go to the next states. Because we don't want to, because there is a song up and that is copyrighted, so. We remove this freezer. And we add full power freezer. Let's start. Oh. Okay, here we go. Second anniversary. I'm the strongest in the universe. Okay, that looks like it's a beast rotation. I see. Okay, just so that you guys know, the reason that I picked this Freezer for the team is for the simple fact he does a guaranteed crit when he's up against a Goku, and he also gets an extra. You know, extra attack and such, it's quite good for this fight. These are the types of fights where certain villain types units will really shine, and that is what we want. Except when you are up against against fusions or such, then it becomes a bit more of a problem. Okay. Another one. Does this fight have a second stage or not? Nope. I'm strongest in the universe. Oh, that's not so bad. The number does this. Cooler can do this. Yeah, that's good. Just so that you guys know, I also recently rainbowed my Frieza. I'm super happy, so. Will the Nimba absorb it? No. Come on. Okay, another one of Lisa.
Allow me to show you just how much more evolved I have become.
Yes, we worship Golden Frieza. He has a gold body. Yes, we worship Golden Frieza. I'll be let Kula finish this. Yes, we worship Golden Frieza. Yes, we worship Golden Frieza. He has a golden body. Because we worship Golden Frieza. And now we're gonna put the sound softer. Just so that we don't get the copyright again, because we hate that. Not that it would have any problems for my channel or anything, but it is just you don't know with Toei Animation sometimes. So one time they are cool with everything, and then the other time they are like. Total wet jobs. Okay, we are going to take on the third anniversary, which was horrible, to be honest. They gave us like the worst. These were the first Dokkenfest LRs, but they were also the worst Dokkenfest LRs at the same time, because they had like the most poorly aging categories in the game to this day. So we are going to fight LR Trash Gito and LR Vilgeta. Man, I was pissed when I put those units, because they were not so good. Everyone's hyping them up and everything, and I was like, they suck.
Allow me to show you just how much more evolved I have become.
I, for example, when we had the Potara Super Battle Road. I did it with Kefla, with the physical Kefla, because physical Kefla gave defense. And not only that, but she could attack multiple times, which was actually really, really, and I mean really good. Is it this? This? And this. Because at the time that was extremely good, the defense. Already. But back then everyone was attack and such, and I went for balanced stats, like attack, defense, and HP. Physical Kefla was really, and I mean really good. Because she could, for example, she could attack multiple times. Yes, I don't think that she stacked. No, it didn't stack, no. But she could attack multiple times. That worked really well when she dodged. Holy shit, there's a lot of attacks, Frieza. And people were like, yeah, but because for me at the time was like, you need units that you can rely on, and people were like, yeah, but they are good, especially. And the thing was, back in those days, nothing lasts long enough for you to till they fuse, you know, so. For that case, they were already useless for me. I mean, especially since you are a global player, but because who would have we had a month before we had the third anniversary? Well, I'm gonna tell you who we had. We had Odrin Stingoku. And he is better than both of these ORs back then. He was way better. Way better. Because he only had a requirement, that is get your HP low to a certain percentage. And he goes into Mastered Ultra Instinct. With these guys, you had to wait 7 turns, and that was way too short. And I mean, way, 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 way too short. Let's see. Ooh, the defense is nice. Already. You get this. And Freeze, what is your defense? Oh man, this feels good. Okay. And then you had those truth followers, and they are like, yeah, you don't know what the shit, you just sold it. I had them. I just never used them. You know when I started to use them, when we got those legendary Goku event missions, the Potara and the Fusion. That is the first time when I started leveling them, and I'm happy that I missed out on these guys, because they are not good. Because the first time that my LR Vegito transformed, got supered. And I lost all my HP. Same goes for Gogeta. And that was in the end fight. And it was not, yeah, it was not fun. It was really, that was really, really, and I mean really, not fun, because I had more luck with other units than that I had luck with those two LRs. And that's a sad thing, and then we had the blue fusions. The blue fusions came out later on. That was I think the 5th anniversary. Yeah. So I did link level them for that, to see maybe they are better with them, because I did it for the blue fusions, because I believe, well, maybe the blue fusions will function better once they are, well, no. A disappointment.
En even met ECA, terwijl Gogeta, de LR Gogeta, became a big improvement. Felt a bit better to use. But I had to fill up a slot, because I needed a physical unit, so I used Gogeta. That one worked, Vegito is still trash. LR Vegito is still trash as fuck. And same. And Gogeta is still not any better, but a bit better than what he was in the... But every time with Vegito in Red Zone, he got me killed. Vegito got me more killed than Gogeta. Gogeta at least dodged a bit, or he could take a hit and such. But Vegito, no. Vegito was horrible. ECA Vegito. Third anniversary Vegito, Super Vegito. I prefer the SDR one, and I prefer the tech, and I prefer the SDR Super Vegito and Super Gogeta. And that is my honest opinion. People don't have to like it that I say that, but I'm not gonna say anything else. So yeah. Holy shit, they did damage. And that is just my honest opinion at the end of the day. I mean, these are like the worst LRs that they ever brought out in Dokkan. LR Super Vegito and LR Super Gogeta for the 3rd anniversary. Hands down the worst units that they ever made. Poorly aged. And they have literally categories that are barely getting updated.
I've made my new form gold, so it's clear who's sitting atop the pecking order.
That's why I was happy with when we had the 5th anniversary fusions. They actually redeemed these, them. To be honest, the Super Saiyan 4s, both the 2nd and the 4th anniversary, they were good. Those were good. Those were a good representation of the... They were really good units for Super Saiyan 4 Goku and Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta. That was like a perfect match. Holy shit, that was a lot of damage. But the 3rd was like horrible. They gave Gogeta and Vegito and really bad units. And then we had the STR one from the World Wide, and then and the Tech one from Tanabata. Those two were chef kiss. They were really good. Really good units. Thank you. Not gonna lie, those were really good units. But and then we got, and like I said, then we had the 5th anniversary with the Blue Fusions, and Blue Fusions were like, oh my god, they were great. I cannot complain about those. Those are so good. Sadly, they were, out of the meta really fast because of their low beginning stats, and they were, and those kinds of things. But damn, they redeemed Vegito, and they redeemed Gogeta with those two on the 5th anniversary. So every anniversary except the third one was complete crap. And I keep saying the third one was complete crap, it should have been Goku and Vegeta. Or no, Goku and Vegeta, I mean Goku and Frieza. Because it went towards Namek, and that was Goku and Frieza. But we never got those. Okay, guys, I think we're gonna stop here. We did all of these events till the third one, and I think after that we had the 4th anniversary. But I think that is where it will become more difficult. So, just so that you guys see, that was the team. So we will now. We'll see you guys with the next one, eh? This was KMK, seeing your YouTube videos and sign naar and arrivederci. And I hope to see you all next time. KMK out. Bye, and stay safe out there.